Kevin, close your eyes. Now, I want you to picture the love of your life. Imagine that you have 30 seconds to win her back.
I love her.
One shot, three sentences. What are those sentences, and who are you saying them to?
You got it.
I got it.
Hi. Before you say anything, those three sentences I need to say to you, okay? I was head over heels in love with you the moment that I saw you. I never should have let you get away.
Are you mad at me about something?
No, of course not.
Then what is it? The best of
my time. So if I made a horrible mistake, that I'll regret for the rest of my life.
It's like you were part of me. Like you were my arm, and when I lost you, it was like I lost my arm. I really want my arm back. You know, because I never stopped thinking about it. Fred sees you look amazing. By the way, and parentheses. Period. You didn't say anything at all?
Kevin.
Yeah.
My ex-husband, who I haven't seen in 12 years, just shows up at my doorstep unannounced. You know, I'm not exactly sure what you want me to say.
Come in.
I can't say that.
Okay. You say you'll think about meeting up with me. Maybe we can have a conversation. Just talk to you. So here's the thing. This is a special booth, all right? It was at this booth where my ex-wife and I had lunch during our 8th grade class trip, Statue of Liberty. And I got seasick on the ferry ride out there. It was awful until she kissed me. Right? And that happened right here at this booth. And it was also at this very booth where we had a conversation where we decided that I was gonna follow my dreams. And I was going to move to Los Angeles, and she was going to stay here, and we sat here until the place closed, trying to convince each other that we could handle the distance.
It's pilot season, and she wants me to go to L.A. for a few months so she can send me on auditions.
What about you? Are you going with
us? Oh, I have school, so.
Yeah, and I'll be back before she can even miss me.
We were wrong. And now, here we are. It's been 12 years, and she's agreed to meet me here today, so. Gee, I really need this booth. Oh, God, you look phenomenal.
What the hell's the matter with you, Kevin?
Stunning.
Huh? Who the hell do you think you are just showing up at my doorstep like that? Do you have any idea how invasive that is? You better be dying, and soon. But you're not, are you? No, look at you. You're glowing. God, that's so annoying. Why don't you age? I only came here today to tell you to go screw yourself.
Love a fries.
I forgot how much I love watching you eat like a truck driver.
You just think that because you'd be like a rabbit.
Maybe.
So why now, Kevin? Why did you come find me?
Because I never stopped thinking about you. So tell me, you know, everything. Start from the beginning. I want to know everything that happened to you since the last time I saw you.
I'm a nurse manager at Manhattan General Hospital.
Wow, nurse manager. That sounds great. Are you like the best nurse? You're the top nurse.
Yeah, I'm pretty badass.
Yeah, you are. So nice to talk to you, you know? Finally pick up where we left off.
Where we left off? Have you just forgotten where we left off?
No, I didn't. That's not what I meant.
You know what? I'm sorry. It's a mistake.
No, no, no. Just calm down. Hold on. Sophie, hold on. Okay. Sophie, hold on a second. You know, I forgot how fast you are in heels. Can you please just slow down a little bit? I just want to talk to you. What did I say? Sophie, will you please just slow down?
Just leave me alone.
Why don't you stop so I can at least talk to you for a second?
About what? Where we left off? Kevin, where we left off was you cheating on me and ruining our marriage.
Okay, listen, that's fair. You want to talk about the cheating? Fine, let's talk about the cheating.
No, I don't want to do this with you.
I can tell you're anxious. Biting your nails, which is what you always do when you're anxious. I also know you get claustrophobic when you're stuck in a place for too long, so I just wanted to come over here and ease your mind, tell you in any second. But the train's gonna start moving, okay?
How's Kate? Earth to Kate! Oh. What? Did you see the ring?
Good.
Yes.
Good? I'm great, actually. She's great. She's engaged. Yeah.
Wow.
I know. Great guy, too. I really like him. It's good.
What about Randall and Rebecca?
Good. You know.
Miguel.
Okay. You know, just, you know.
Oh, it's been so hard on him.
Because he's, you know, obviously.
Come on, how's my sweet little make
you? Don't do it. Oh, just, I really hate it when you call him that. I've always hated it.
I know.
Oh, God. Sorry to hear about your mom's in a mess. It's tough.
You know, don't you know about that?
Oh, yeah. It turns out you and I are Facebook friends.
No, we're not.
Except that we are.
No, we're not.
I'm Soo-hee Jeong.
What?
That's me. Sorry. Yeah, no, I created a fake profile because I want to keep up with you.
You did not.
I did, indeed.
You're Soo-hee.
Yep. In the flesh.
Ah.
Sorry about that, folks. Ooh. Have a nice street stop now.
I just want you to know that I've changed, okay? Truly.
You know, after we split up, I moved back in with my parents. I dated a bunch of jerks. I even married one of them. Surprise, surprise, that didn't work out. I wasn't in a good place for a long time. But I'm happy now. I like my job, and I have an apartment with exposed brick.
You love exposed brick.
I really do. I can't wait until Kev and I get to host Thanksgiving one day in our amazing loft with exposed brick that we'll buy when Kevin becomes a famous actor. And I'm finally dating a nice guy. He's an x-ray technician, and he's solid.
I'm not, solid.
No, Sophie, hold on, give me a chain. Hold on, Sophie. Hold on a second, listen. If you're in love with this x-ray technician guy, I don't want to be happy, okay? I want you to be happy.
But do you remember what you wore the first day of fourth grade?
No, of course not.
You walking into my fourth grade class, Sophie, that's the best thing that ever happened to me in my entire life. Actually, scratch that. That's not true. It's the second best thing that ever happened to me. The best thing that ever happened to me was you telling me that you'd marry me.
I got married to Sophie.
I'm still in love with you. And I will be at a restaurant bright and early tomorrow. I'll be sitting in our booth waiting for you. Remember Sophie, right? My ex-wife? Well, we're dating.
Does it hurt?
Your leg. You broke the hell out of that leg.
Did I?
You know you did.
I know I did.
So? Novak?
Oh, yeah, Novak was a no-show. Matter. No.
You've been talking about it for days.
It's because I thought the play was the only thing that mattered. Yeah. I didn't come to New York to be in a hit play. I came to New York to win back my girl. I'm not messing things up with you again. And however long it takes for me to convince you of that, I'll just wait. I came here for you, Sophie. I'm prepping a movie right now that I'm going to direct. It shoots in a couple of months in Los Angeles. Perfect.
I would?
Absolutely. I'd really like to send you this script.
Meeting with the director, okay? It's not like I'm going to get the part.
Don't do that. I want you to get it.
Fun of me.
Kevin, you've been eating 6 ounces of plain chicken breast every meal for the last 2 weeks. Your ab game is strong, I promise.
Yeah, I know. Look, I know this whole thing seems stupid, but this is a big deal to me, you know? I mean, you're here, right? My whole family's flying in. The man, he made me, Soph. It made me, and then it ruined me. And now they ask me to return to do this special episode, but really, I'm just returning to the scene of the crime, right? Let's be honest.
Will you do your meltdown for me?
Huh?
That thing from TNZ when you quit?
No.
Oh, come on. It was my favorite thing from the show.
Babe, that was not part of the show. That was a bad moment in my life. I'm not...
Why are you watching this crap?
Okay.
Shame on you for making me famous. Shame on all of us.
No, it's not even close, babe. I was losing. I can't feel my face right now. Shame on you for making me famous. Shame on me for taking the money. Shame on all of us. Please be nice to Sophie, please.
Kev, you know we like her more than you.
This is what I keep telling you.
Yeah, okay,
him.
So the tour's over. I'm gonna go get ready.
You are beautiful, like I've never seen you.
Where the hell were you, Kevin?
Heard that you and Sophie got divorced?
Yeah. We did.
I'm short of breath,
Sophie.
Standing next to you. I'll be the dangerous.
Should I move?
Can you give me a second, please?
We tried again. We tried to squeeze a puzzle piece in because it fit once when we were kids.
So this whole party was for Sophie.
I guess. Just leave me with something. Just leave me with the past. Just let me remember you at 10 or at 17 or 20. Just let me remember you when it was good. Okay? Well, you can check my name off your list. Do it with a clear conscience, because I forgive you. No, I already...
didn't know that you weren't just a name on my list. So if you were the name,
goodbye, Kevin. What are you doing lurking outside of my apartment?
I wasn't. Oh, no, I wasn't lurking. Well, I was coming from the community center. I was walking the train, and I didn't realize how close your place was until I actually got to your street. So I was going to walk an extra block, you know, to avoid the whole thing, but it's raining, so I thought, well, I'll just walk right past your place. And then I got here, and I started lurking.
What were you doing at the community center in Park Slope?
I was at an AA meeting. Yeah, I've been going to different neighborhoods. I'm trying to find a good fit, but don't worry about it. I'll mark this one off for sure. I'm sorry. Have a good night, Soph. I'm sorry. Bye.
Kevin, wait. Are you okay? I'm only asking because when you broke up with me, I just spent a lot of time wondering if you were okay. I also wanted to kill you. It was like 50% wondering, 50% wanting to kill. More like 70-30.
70% wondering if I was okay and 30% wanting to kill me?
No.
Got it. I'm okay.
Okay, good.
Can we go get a coffee?
I'm engaged.
Oh. Well, then a coffee should be safe.
And does he work at the hospital as well?
He's a kindergarten teacher.
Oh.
I met him at my friend Allison's birthday party.
Allison? I remember Allison. She's the one that hates me.
No, that was Alicia.
Alicia hates me.
Yeah, but now Allison hates you too.
Really?
Yeah. Now everyone I know hates you.
Okay, fair enough. No, well, okay, go on.
Well, it was only like a month after we broke up. I wasn't even going to go to the party because I was still in my, like, only wear sweatpants and rewatch every episode of Friends phase. But she convinced me, and there was Grant sitting at the piano playing She's Always a Woman. He's from Long Island, so Billy Joel's pretty much his god.
Yeah, of course.
We locked eyes, and it was one of those stupid, magical moments. 6 months later, he put a ring on it.
It's a beautiful ring.
Thank you.
So you guys gonna have kids, or? I'm sorry, don't answer that. That's none of my business. Zoe doesn't want kids. Like, ever. And I don't know what I want, but I need to make a decision before she commits to spending time with me, and I need to choose between a life without Zoe or a life without kids, right? Which really sucks for me because I'm bad at making choices.
Yeah, well, that's probably because you're not used to doing it.
What do you mean?
Yeah, you always got it all. I mean, our entire lives, you were able to get exactly what you wanted just by being you. Zoe sounds like she's really good for you.
Yeah.
She got you to go to couples counseling. I mean, I couldn't even get you to see Amelie.
Oh. That's
awesome. Yeah, okay.
Decide what you want. You always get it.
And I can put myself in these obviously terrible situations because I'm so desperate to have this crazy love story like what my parents had, but maybe it's just not in the cards for me, Noah. You know what I mean? Maybe it is just not in the cards. Here, you take that. I gotta concentrate.
Trust me, Kevin. This is the ending everyone wants, and they still won't see it coming.
Huh. Mr. Pearson, sir?
Yeah.
Your phone keeps ringing. Oh. She says it's important. I didn't want to interrupt.
Take it.
You sure?
Definitely.
Thanks.
Yeah. Hey, Soph, you okay? Is it all right?
She's gone. Kev, my mom.
What?
She died yesterday.
Soph, I'm so sorry.
It's weird that I called, right?
No. No, of course not.
Grant, you know, that's my fiance's name, Grant. He's been really great with all the logistical stuff, but, you know, both of his parents are still...
Soph, hey. Okay, Soph, I got one for you. I got one for you. You ready?
Ready.
He starts a cider brewing company, and he calls it How Do You Like Them Apples?
Well done, Kevin. Thank you. I should go.
Hey, Soph. I'm really sorry. She was a force of nature.
Anyone home at your house?
Hello.
There's my beautiful daughter.
Hi.
And there he is, my beautiful superstar son-in-law. Ah, I saw you on Days. So convincing I could have cried. And still, movie star handsome under all that yellow makeup.
Well, you know they cut my line.
So, you go back and get one next time.
Yeah.
Hey, give me your eyes. Never settle.
Never will.
Yeah. I'm so proud of you.
Sucks.
Movies. And donuts.
Yes. I love you so much.
I love you so much.
And now we'll hear a few words from Claire's daughter, Sophie.
My mother was impossible. I know I'm not supposed to say that at her funeral, but she was. She couldn't sit still in any sense of the phrase. Even when she was diagnosed with MS, she refused to stop moving. She never settled. When I finally got my dream apartment in Brooklyn, she came to visit and tour the neighborhood. And we found this coffee shop. This real hole in the wall, but it became our spot. Every time she visited, and even when she couldn't fly anymore, I would always bring her fresh beans from there every time I came home. I was there when I found out that she had died. I was being rude to this poor clerk over how they were out of their house blend. You know, I mean, how do you run out of your house blend, right? It's like, I was just grumpy from a night shift. What I wouldn't give to go back to that moment. That moment before. She was still alive, and my biggest concern was Kophie. Sorry.
Come, my love, I'll tell you a tale of a boy and girl.
I have to ask you something.
Spell it.
Well, obviously I couldn't give Sophie your dream wedding, but I'm hoping I can give her the ring that she's always wanted. Her grandmother's emerald ring. She said that you were saving it for her.
Okay. You're gonna have huge success, and it's gonna take you lots of places.
Is that a yes?
I love you, kiddo. But I can't give you that ring. Not yet. Your marriage is too new. And you're too young. You gotta earn it, baby doll.
Hey.
Hi.
I would ask how you're doing, but
I can't believe you came.
How could I not come?
Are you headed back right now? I'm sure you got so much going on.
What if I told you I was thinking about maybe coming to the reception? What would you say?
Okay, good.
I'm standing on the front lawn right now.
So if I'm looking at you and I'm... brought you these donuts from that place that you like so much, you know,
I had two of them on the way over here, I'm not gonna lie to you, but I saved the powdered ones because I remember how much you love those.
You got a little face on your crumbs right there. Let me get it for you.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Wasn't sure if I should come in.
No, that's probably not a good idea. Don't you know that these storybook lovers always have a happy ending? Give me a
hand. And on his stallion.
there anywhere you want to go? Is that your grandmother's ring? It's a nice ring. Pretty. Grant's got great taste.
He never really got to know her. I mean, they met a few times, but she was so sick. Crazy, I'm gonna spend the rest of my life with someone who never really knew her. You know, at the funeral today, I was about to lose it.
I know.
But I found you there, and I locked in on you.
Grief is a tricky thing, you know, you just can't prepare for how it's gonna make you feel or how you'll handle it. Sometimes you just gotta grab onto whatever's around you just to survive. Plus, we have a history of getting each other through funerals.
Okay, I've got one. You ready?
If you got one, I'm ready.
He decides he has to get away. As far away as he can. So he becomes an ice fisherman in Alaska. And he never talks to another human being again.
Wow. Well done. So can I take you somewhere? Here we are. You remember this place?
Of course I do. How can I forget? Oh, sorry.
Huh?
Oh.
I swear. You know, I'm gonna be sick, yeah.
Maybe we should have waited until they fixed the projector.
No.
What do you mean, nah? Now we'll never know how it ended.
Yeah, but until it blacked out, wasn't it like the perfect movie? I mean, the real ending could never have been good enough. This way, we can imagine the perfect ending to the perfect movie for the rest of our lives. I got an ending for you. Ready?
Ready.
Will realizes that he's in love with the best friend, the tall guy, and they run away together. The whole thing was a gay love story. Let's never watch the real ending.
Never. I never did you?
No, me either.
Huh.
Wow. That was better than I could have possibly imagined.
Yeah. And here I thought I had the whole thing figured out with that cider company.
Thank you.
Man, I really messed things up with Sophie. A couple of times, actually. I never earned that ring.
Even back then, through all this time.
Hello?
Kevin, hi.
Sophie, hey.
I saw your magazine cover about your engagement and the twins and... I don't know, it just felt weird not to call and say congratulations.
I love you, Sophie. And I can see our whole lives together. That's my ultimate dream, Sophie. You and me. To the very end.
We both know you've been staring at that door, willing Sophie to walk through it all day.
Oh, please. Kevin Pearson doesn't age.
Kevin Pearson ages? My beard's coming in gray.
No,
it is.
Not.
It is. I'm thinking about dyeing it right here in the corner. Check it out. Look at it. Get in there. Take a look.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
You have gray hair. You are not allowed to dye that.
I said I was thinking about dyeing
it. No, I forbid it. Check out that view.
Yeah. You seem really happy, so I'm glad you found someone.
I am really happy, Kev. Are you okay? I told you she was going to be here with her husband. I'm also divorced. Dating?
Am I dating?
Have you been dating?
Well, you're probably exhausted.
Okay, I just got a second
smells the same.
Not the same.
So blessed, it's like picking out a lineup.
No, it's not the same.
Okay. What's happening?
I can't do this.
Well, hold on. Why not? Because I like the smell of your shampoo?
No, because you should like how my hair smells now, not how it smelled in the past.
Sophie, come on.
I'm sorry.
Well, I'm so confused. I don't understand what's going on.
You know, Grant and I used to have this inside joke that whenever you were on TV, he would pretend to fast forward, you know, and he would make the sound like the old TiVo used to make.
All right, here you go.
some random Tuesday night, there you were again on TV, and, you know, he did the thing like he always did, and I tried to play along with it. I did, but I don't know, I couldn't do it anymore. I don't know what it was about that moment, but I just realized that I'm never going to be able to fast forward through you. I'll be by your side. That's the kind of hold you've had over me, Kevin. That's how much I have carried you with me.
And I have carried you with me, Soph. I have.
It's too much. Kevin, it's too much. We have decades of history between us.
Why is that a bad thing?
Because I can't go backwards.
I don't want to go backwards.
I can't do this. I can't. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'll be there to fall
into the dark to chase your heart. He'll figure things out. They just got married so young. High school first love. And Kevin needs some time to figure things out with her.
We were just talking about you.
No, we weren't about that.
Did you get any sleep?
A little, yeah. You?
Yeah. See you at the wedding.
Yeah.
I think I'm just done with love.
Now, Edge. Now, Edge is what brings us together today. A dream within a dream. What tomorrow brings
these weary eyes. The timing is just off right now. He isn't ready for you. He will be. But it's gonna take a while.
So let me get this straight. The woman you pined after for years is finally single, and you're depressed about it.
I don't wanna mess it up again.
Not gonna happen, Captain.
You and Sophie together.
Now that makes more sense than this thing.
Hey.
Talk to you?
Yeah?
Yes, sure.
Okay.
Yes.
Wait a second.
I was actually gonna come over and
I don't want you to be a ball that I just bounce off of to get to another ball.
What? Wait, just stop. I listen, you don't get to give this much to the stomach. It's my turn.
Okay.
I have spent years of my life praying that you would grow up. Now here you are, 20 years later. And you're finally the man that I always knew you was.
I'll find my way back to you. I'll find my way back to you. I'll find my way back to you. I'll find my way back.